Welcome to week 36 of your 40-week pregnancy journey. While you are not yet considered full term, get ready. 13% of all pregnant women go into labor before 37 weeks. There are only 4 more weeks to go. Your baby's development at week 36. At 36 weeks pregnant, baby is as big as a papaya, measuring about 18.7 inches from crown to heel and weighing in about 5.8 pounds. When you are 36 weeks pregnant, your baby's skull bones are not fused together yet, so the head can easily maneuver through the birth canal. Your baby's skull is not the only soft structure in her little body. Most of her bones and cartilage are quite soft as well, allowing for an easier journey into the world during delivery. But don't worry, they'll harden over the first few years of her life. By now, many of the baby's symptoms are pretty mature, at least in baby terms, and just about ready for life on the outside. Blood circulation, for instance, has been perfected, and your baby's immature system has developed enough to protect your little one from infections outside the womb. Others, however, still need a few finishing touches. One such noticeable example, digestion, which actually won't be fully mature until sometime after birth. Because inside her little gestational cocoon, your baby has relied on the umbilical cord for nutrition, meaning that the digestive system, though developed, has not been operational. The sonograph this week shows that your baby's heart beats around 110 to 160 beats per minute. Your common symptoms this week. Some of the symptoms which you may experience during this week might include: number 1, heartburn and indigestion. Early in pregnancy, your body produces large amounts of hormones, progesterone and relaxin, which tend to relax smooth muscle tissues throughout your body, including those in your gastrointestinal tract. Heartburns occur when the ring of the muscle that separates the esophagus from the stomach relaxes, allowing the food and harsh digestive juices to back up from the stomach to the esophagus. Number 2, bloating. Bloating may be one of your most frequent and least charming pregnancy symptoms. While progesterone is essential for maintaining a healthy pregnancy, it also triggers the delightful trio that includes bloating, burping, and passing gas. Progesterone causes the smooth muscle tissues in your body to slow down and relax. This also leads to bloating and passing gas. Number 3, constipation. As with many other pregnancy symptoms, pregnancy hormones are the culprit behind constipation. Progesterone causes the muscles in your bowels to relax, allowing the food to hang around longer in the digestive tract. Number 4, leucorrhea, that is vaginal discharge. When you're expecting, an increase in estrogen level causes increased blood flow to the pelvic area. More blood flow stimulates the body's mucous membranes, leading to an increase in vaginal discharge in early pregnancy and beyond. Pregnancy discharge removes dead cells from the vagina, protects the birth canal from infection, and maintains a healthy balance of bacteria in the vagina. So here are some self-care tips during this week. Some of the self-care tips which you should follow during this week might include: number 1, preventing heartburn and indigestion. There are several ways to control and treat heartburn during pregnancy, and with so many options and so much time, you'll probably try them all, such as: chew on sugarless gums, add almonds to your diet, because eating a few almonds after each meal, since they are very tasty and neutralize the juices in the stomach, which may relieve and prevent heartburn. Get milk, eat fresh, dried or freeze-dried papaya, as it helps to relieve heartburn for some women and scores vitamin A and vitamin C too. Number 2, preventing bloating. Some of the tips to reduce bloating during pregnancy include: drink plenty of water, which helps to keep things moving through your digestive system to avoid constipation. Eating plenty of fiber is another way to curb pregnancy constipation, including leafy green vegetables, legumes, whole grains, etc. Opt for smaller meals rather than big meals. Try to relax and cut back on the beans. Number 3, preventing constipation. You don't have to resign yourself to 9 months of discomfort. There are plenty of tactics to combat constipation. That is, fight back with fiber. Fiber-rich foods help you eliminate waste. Aim for 25 to 35 grams of fiber each day. Resist refined. Try to avoid refined grains, which include white bread, white rice, refined cereals and pasta. Drink about 8 to 10 glasses of fluids a day. Don't max out at your meal time. Go when you got to go. Consider your supplements and medication. Do your Kegel muscle exercises. Stay away from stimulant laxatives. Number 4, preventing leucorrhea. Here are some tips on what to do about vaginal discharge when you are pregnant. Bathe regularly and wear underpants with breathable cotton liners. Wear pads or panty liners. Leave the douches at the drugstore. Don't bother with the wipes, as your vagina is self-cleaning. So in the nutshell, here is your week 36 checklist. Continue taking prenatal vitamins. Continue drinking about 8 to 12 glasses of water a day. Continue doing your Kegel exercises daily. Continue doing your daily perineal massages. Gather any lingering labor and delivery questions for your healthcare provider. Thank you. Please like, subscribe and share our YouTube channel, The Voice of Women, and press the bell icon to stay tuned for the latest updates.